truth and nothing but the truth.
I do.
World-renowned pulmonologist Dr. Martin Tobin, who wrote what's referred to as the Bible of Mechanical Breathing, told jurors what he believes caused George Floyd to die.
You're seeing here fatal injury to the brain from a lack of oxygen.
His analysis of the death contradicting the defense's argument that drugs and underlying medical conditions caused Floyd to die.
Do any of those conditions have anything to do with the cause of Mr. Floyd's death, in your professional opinion, whatsoever?
None whatsoever.
Tobin used a 3D rendering of the scene to explain to the jury how he feels Floyd's lungs were put in a vise. He said the handcuffs cranked upward while Floyd was in the prone position on a hard street with knees on the neck, back, side, and arm all contributed to Floyd essentially suffocating.
You see his knuckle against the tire. And to most people, this doesn't look terribly significant, but to a physiologist, this is extraordinarily significant. So he's using his fingers and his knuckles against the street to try and crank up the right side of his chest. This is his only way to try and get air to get into the right lung.
Chauvin's defense attorney pushing back at Tobin.
You've taken this case and you've literally boiled it down into a nanosecond.
Oh, I wouldn't say that.
A toxicologist who tested Floyd's blood in the investigation testified that the levels of methamphetamine and fentanyl in Floyd's system were much lower than what is typical in overdose victims and were more akin to what they see in DUI cases. The defense took shots at the quality of the data the expert was relying on for comparison.
A couple ways to assess this.
The final witness Thursday, Dr. William Smock, an emergency physician who works for Louisville PD. He testified that Floyd's actions were not of someone suffering a drug overdose.
He's breathing. He's talking. He's not snoring. He is saying, you know, please, please get off of me. I want to breathe. I can't breathe. That is not a fentanyl overdose. That is somebody begging to breathe.
Three medical experts today. Tomorrow, another absolute key medical expert, as the state is expected to call Hennepin County Medical Examiner Dr. Andrew Baker, who performed George Floyd's autopsy. Randy.
All right. Thank you, Chris.
Though many found today's testimony compelling, it's important to remember we've only heard from prosecution witnesses so far. We spoke to criminal defense attorney Mike Bryant about the duties the state has versus the defense.
So the state has to, through their evidence, through their experts, through everybody they bring in, they have to, when they rest, be able to say, this is our case and we win based upon our case. If they have a hole in that or they don't prove all the elements, they lose. And the defense's job is only to really put holes in things. They don't have to prove anything as far as it goes. The defendant often will bring in evidence so that it can show what are wrong with their case. They'll attack their case. They'll put holes in their case. Because what they want is one or two of the jurors to go back in the jury room with questions that were unanswered.
So again, we've been hearing the state present its case. They will likely wrap up early next week, and then the defense will begin calling its witnesses.